You were a big hockey guy too.
Enjoy it. So, well, anyway. here, let's look at the Olympian Tommasoni.
Well, this one is actually a club team that I played for in Italy by the name of Murano. Murano is in northeastern Italy, just south of Innsbruck, Austria, and so we won the Italian championship with this particular club team. And then a whole bunch of us on this team ended up playing on the Italian national team. But
point you out here.
Well, this is me here.
Okay, right here.
Yep, and I'll give you an example of how many there were. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of us who had Italian passports and could play on the team as Italians. And then there were a couple guys that were Canadians that also played on the team. So it was this was really a good hockey team that I played on.
Oh, was there a nickname that you can share on the air that for you?
Yeah, they called me, this is funny, they called me the Iron Man. Okay. And it was, the reason was because my first team that I played with was a team by the name of Val Gardena near Murano. And they wanted me to give them some publicity or some kind of articles about my college career.
Yeah.
And so I gave them the college. What's it called? The booklet where they have all the people listed and everything. You know, where you got the roster of all the players and everything. And they got a little bio of all of us in this book.
Yeah.
And in my bio, my senior year, it said he's an Iron Man from an Iron Country because I hadn't missed any games in my college career.
Does that surprise me?
Yeah. And so when they saw this, they started calling me Iron Man, and they didn't exactly know why.
Yes.
But the funny part about it was when they translated it into Italian, it was Uomo di Acciaio, and that translates as Man of Steel. So I kind of like that one better.
Yeah, the range and all that.
Hey, and then this is my picture. You'll like this one. This up here you can't. But this is my picture with Gretzky, and that's Wayne Gretzky, and this is in
the great one.
Yeah, this is in 1982 in the World Championships
in
Finland. And I like to tell people that Gretzky's already lost a puck and he's about to go down.
Okay. And then here's one of you.
Yeah, that's when I still had hair, and that was in about 1976, and we were about to play with the Italian
and
national
your
team.
Position again?
I was a defenseman.
Defenseman,
yeah.
Okay.
Well,
great, and here, we're going to just go over here. We'll have session before too long, fun.
Yeah, this is good.
What would you like to share over here?
The flag is
Vice President Biden.
As you can see, this flag was flown over the United States Embassy in Kabul, in Afghanistan, and one of my friend's kids from the Iron Range actually got that flag for me, and so I thought that was a pretty important thing. And this is a picture walking into the chamber during the Vikings debate back in 2012, and I think it was on the front page of the Trib, wasn't it? And I was walking in there, and one of the guards was there, and that was the only me and that guard were the only ones walking into the chamber that day, and they took that picture, but. These pictures over here are...
Yeah, you got Harmon Killebrew and Kirby Puckett. Here, let's walk over here.
Harmon and Kirby came to the House of Representatives. This was April 3rd of 2000, and it was the 40th season for the Twins. And so we did a resolution, and I was the author of the resolution. And both Harmon and Kirby came to participate in it, and they both signed the resolution. So it was
Wanted to get a picture with them.
And it was unbelievable. They were being mobbed in the retiring room in the house, and I actually had to grab them and pull them away so that they could get away from everybody. And then we took that picture there. This is a couple of years ago. Joe Biden came up to the Iron Range, and I got to fly with him.
Vice President. And you had a big hearing up in the Iron Range.
Yep. This was on Air Force Two, so I'm sitting at his desk, and in the airplane, and he was just a really really fun guy to talk to. I actually told him to run for president then, but I think he could have won.
Okay.
And then these pictures here are just pictures of the mines that we have on the Iron Range, and this is a picture of Mintac. This is Mountain Iron, and you can see the mine in the background and the taconite plant in the background here. Most of these things, these water type like this is a pit that filled up with water that used to be mined, and then this is Hibbing taconite, and this is west of Chisholm and north of Hibbing, and then This is the earlier on in my career in 1994 with Representative Rucavina and Senator Doug Johnson. And that's a production, that's a 240-ton production truck in the background. We were at a...
Those tires are much taller than you guys.
Yeah, that's why I put this picture in here, so you can see how tall, how big those tires are. They're about 12 feet high. And they last probably about 6 to 8 months, and I think they cost about $18,000 each.
Yes.
Yeah, so pretty interesting stuff.
Well, thank you for sharing that. And well, we'll conclude over here as we got to get back to work in a little bit. But
how
would you like to just sum up the legislative career so far?
Well, I think it's gratifying. I think any time you do a job like this, you you have ups and downs. You have people telling you you did really good things, and some people don't agree with what you do. But that's the kind of job it is. And it's the other part of the job is it's. What have you done for me lately? And so it's kind of like regardless of how successful you've been or how much you produce, it's a new day. And so every single day is a new lesson. Every single day is a new product. And every single day you try and accomplish something good. And I think what we do here is to try and do what we can that's best for the people of the state of Minnesota, and not just our own little areas, but for the entire state, because we are state senators and not just a local senator. And so, like we said earlier, compromise is the issue, and we have to get there eventually.
Great. Senator Tom Soni, thank you. Grazie.
Prego.
Thank you, Pete. Okay.